new member of the Collier Sir Mostyn boxing setup in Adan Muhammad, who is 8-0, seen you fight before on some of the BT shows, you know, a real good talented prospect. Pat, how did it end up London and Manchester United?
Well, to be honest with you, I've always been part of London, what a lot of people don't know. So I based the setup down there a long time ago, and we both got like the same kind of a mutual friend, C1, and we had a talk, and we got introduced that way, and the boxer himself spoke with us. And normally it's not me really to take on an 8-0 fighter, but you know, I also spoke with his coach, and we made some form of agreement that this was the best decision for him to make, to come up to get away so he can focus on his career.
Yeah, well, it's great to, I was just saying to you earlier, it's strange to hear like a proper Cockney accent in Manchester, but it's kind of nice to hear that as well. How are you finding Manchester, for a start?
Manchester's nice. It's more chilled, you can do what you want really. It's a new environment for me. Sometimes in the gym you might hear a Manny accent and it's giving you a headache.
He just made it himself now.
You gotta roll with the punches, Pat.
He's gonna have to roll with the punches now. He just said that.
Yeah, you're with Pat now. You were saying to me before, and you moved away just from some distractions in London, was it? Like, what? Can you tell us a bit more about the situation and why?
Just really growing up, see when you're around the wrong groups and just getting involved in wrong things. Not gonna say just. I'm 8-0 now. There's no point in me stopping now when I've grafted so hard. 7-time national champ, done loads as an amateur, 60 fights. You know what I'm trying to say? There's no point leaving it because you're getting distracted by things around you that you might as well just push on. Yeah. And you ain't got a long career as well. Not long.
Yeah. Well, Pat, you know, it's not, like you say, you're building fighters up who have started from scratch, but you've got a fighter who's 8-0. You must also rate him though, because you know you've got a big stable, and you have said to me in the past that you don't waste time with people in a sense. You must rate him.
You know what? He's talented. He's very talented. There's something about him that's different. And I mean, even for the low weight division, the bantam. What is it, bantam?
Bantamweight.
The bantam. You know, it's very hard, but he's tall. He's big. Like I said, he's done a lot with the amateurs. I mean. He's had a lot of amateur experience, 65 fights, as an amateur, only lost five. So it says a lot. He's won the Europeans, he's won so many cup things, whatever he's doing in the amateur. So, bags of talent, and it's an opportunity to get to work with such a talented fighter as well.
Now, of course, the work begins in earnest. It's a new trainer, new rhythms to work out, new supply. How are you taking to the style?
Just got to soak it in, really. All the boys around me, like, they've given me the blueprint. I'm watching Zofa, Lyndon, even George, Adam, all the boys in the gym now. Just give me the blueprint and just got to soak it up and enjoy it, really.
Yeah. Now obviously, Adam's been on, like, you know, big shows, the BT cards and stuff he started off on. But, you know, there might even be something whilst you're waiting for the next step to actually go on a Black Flash show. Is that right?
You know what? If it ever comes, look, I'm not saying, I mean, look, he's started from... where a lot of these young fighters are trying to start from, which is great. But as he's seen it himself and being around the smaller shows, he sometimes coming back down and, you know, having a look at something different can always keep that tool sharpened. And there's no saying that he is, because like I just said, I mean, he's very experienced. I think. Sometimes with smaller shows, they always reinvent. They always keep the tool sharp. Zalfa did it just before he boxed Leon Woodstock, when he lost his first defeat, and he came back down on the shows after being on TV and had a fight with us, and then fought with us. Because otherwise, he would have been waiting there for the ages. See, sometimes being at the top can be hard because you have a long waiting list of when they're going to put you out again. And all we want to do is fight as his fight. We just want to just get in the ring. We don't care where we get in the ring, who we get in the ring with, where that ring is. We just need, our job is just to be in that ring. So I'm glad he's got that mentality and doesn't think, oh no, I need to be on TV. He likes a small role. He even says, why didn't I not start like this? So it doesn't make a difference, you know what I mean? It's versatile, which is good. Because most kids now, when they're at the top, They're not versatile. They just want to stay one way.
Yeah, and I know that's something that you think is really important, having that versatility. For people in Manchester then, who are going to be getting to see a new kid on the scene, so to speak, what should people be looking at when they look at you then? What's your style all about? What are you all about as a fighter?
Slick, sharp type of fighter. Just watch for the counters.
Watch for the counters.
Yeah.
You know what? Hey, I've got to mention this. Yeah. So you're living with Pat now, is that
yeah,
right?
Yeah, padded up with Pat now, isn't it? Just with my old Pat, mate.
No, I don't know whether that's a good thing or that's a sentence, that's a punishment.
No, that's
what's
a,
it like?
That's a I'll answer that. I don't even see him. He's a Pat, mate. You know what it's like? I say this a million times, and you know, it's like having mice. You just don't see it.
Number 10 for the day, 10 for the day. Mice, hamster, whatever.
You just don't see it. All you see, he sneaks out to the shop and comes back.
I'll be like, you're right, Pat, do you want anything?
So you're in the apartment around the corner?
Yeah, yeah.
Man, that's you know, so living, you're giving us insights here that no one's ever got privy to, yeah. Living with Pat Barrett.
I don't think Pat would let anyone else.
No. I mean, you're surviving so far, though. So far.
Just about.
But is there an element of that? It's a good time to, like, because you can chat boxing all the time, yeah. when you do see each other, bump into each other.
100%. But Pat's put me up, so I've got to impress. I've got to do well. Do you know what I'm trying to say? I've got to show him why he's helped me out. Do you know why he's took me on? Do you know what I'm saying? I can't just come up here and be doing the same thing. Do you know what I'm trying to say? Not developing, not doing anything different. You can't go back the same fighter.
Yeah.
It just don't make sense. That's why even with these small hall shows, even if I go on it, it's keeping the ball rolling, because some of these kids, I boxed last in February, some of these kids have already had two fights since June. Do you know what I'm trying to say? That couple of the boys on the show, they're boxing June, they're boxing again now, they're two fights ahead of me. And they probably boxed the same time as me in February. Do you know what I'm trying to say? It don't make sense having one fight a year. I ain't a world champ. Do you know what I'm trying to say? That Canelo fighting twice a year. I need to be busy.
And you're managed by Alfie Warren, and
Warren,
you
yeah.
have as well now the link up. I'm sure there's that platform if needed
100%,
to jump
yeah.
on a Black Flash show just whilst you
definitely just keep the rust on yeah, rust yeah, off yeah
exactly. It's great to meet you. You know, so we've actually worked out that I have interviewed you years back in Telford.
Yeah.
It's great to see you guys, and it's great to see that someone is living with Pat and still alive to tell the tale.
Yeah, they're talking about you, Pat. Oh my god.
I've got to ask you this, guys, whilst I got you, because we're talking boxing anyway in general. But did you watch boxing at the weekend?
Yeah, yeah.
What did you make of it? There's some big talk going on about the Dubois fight, isn't it?
I don't know, I see the shot, the low blow they called, but when I was watching it I didn't think it was a low blow. But when I watched it back on that, I ain't gonna lie. It was below. Because Usyk didn't have his shorts high. He had them at like a standard level. And then it was under the band. Do you know what I'm trying to say? It weren't nowhere near. So I thought, yeah, definitely a low blow. Now that I've watched it.
Interesting. Pat, do you know how many people have asked me to ask you today? Do you know how many people have said, you've got to ask Pat about what he thinks about it? What did you think about it?
I'm a bit like what Dan said. I mean, when I watched it, you know, you got to really analyse it. And I think you should have that VAR, whatever in boxing. So sometimes the referee can't see everything. If a boxer jumps on the floor and the ref's got the boxer's got his back turned to him, he's more like at the side. You can't see fully if it was. So, me personally, I thought, I would say Dubois was robbed of a world title because it was on borderline. It wasn't exactly there, but it was above there. And it's where the referee would say, if he's seen it, he wouldn't have classed it as a low blow. It's very, what's the word, argumentative to yeah. say.
Can you see the argument for both? You're saying you don't think it was clear cut, but...
It wasn't, you can see the argument from both, because I'm on about in the defence for the referee. The referee would make that decision because he's from that angle, probably, in the reaction of the boxer. He'd probably think, nah, it wouldn't be, you know what I mean?
Doing that for no reason, yeah.
And it's someone like Usyk who's a world champion. Again, there were certain advantages that took it away from Dubois, where he had all the disadvantages. And when you look at it clearly, I think you could say, some would say it was, some would say it wasn't. It's a very argumentative kind of situation.
Do you think if he'd started counting the ref, do you think Usyk would have got up?
I think Usyk would have been the one that would have been... I don't think he would have got up because he played that part. And I think he would have been the one that would have been taking it to the way Warren's taking it, where it was like, let's take this up with the, you know what I mean?
So he would have complained.
Yeah. Okay. Because he would have got counted out. He wouldn't have just jumped up and said it was all right, because it would have made him look terrible that it was a cheat. So either way, he would have had to see it out. I mean, and it was double account, wasn't it?
So, he was down for a long time.
Yeah. It was about 4 minutes or something like that.
I think it was more the pain of the shot, that, because it was a surprise shot that got through where it got you. Mm. You know what I mean? So
fair enough. But look, the debate will rage on. You know what I mean? It's split, yeah. Split people, but I suppose but finally we're talking about boxing. We're talking about a good fight that was on that we've seen. But there we go. What do you think about the closing stages as well? The stoppage and everything.
The fight, I didn't think he got dropped by a jab. I thought he was just tired, physically tired. Like, I thought he was just, you see, Usyk's got you thinking 24/7, so it's tiring. Do you know what I'm going to say? When someone's twitching, someone's moving, someone's doing something every second. So that's a hard fight, do you know what I'm going to say? So I thought Daniel weren't, he didn't get hurt by the shot. I thought he was just a bit knackered, do you know what I'm going to say?
Yeah. What do you make of it when people, because lots of people have come out in the media and said, oh, they've used the word quit. What do you make of it when people use that word?
I don't think he quit. I think the jab was more like, if you look at the jab, it was more like on the side of the chin. And it was a clipping shot. It's just like getting clipped off a left hook. So, you know, it was a nice shot. It was a nice jab. It was something that is winning, and he just come over with it like this. So it was a clipping shot with the knuckle right on the. So, you know.
When you walk onto it, it's 10 times worse as well.
I wouldn't say he quit. I mean, he was doing too good to quit. There was times in the fight where he got hit with good combinations. If he wanted to quit, yeah, I looked at it, would have quit then. I don't think he quit. I think he got hit with a good shot. And I think he did what you call it, because it's happened before. Yard got knocked out with a jab.
Yeah.
So I mean, and again, but that was more like exhaustion.
Yeah, that's
right. And a good jab. But I don't know. I mean, he might be right, but he didn't quit.
Fair enough. Well, you know, back to you guys. I mean, it's great to see a fresh face in Manchester. And I'm sure this journey will progress, and looking forward to seeing you, whether it is on the December show or not, just down at the gym. Great to come and see you down there.
Definitely, 100%.
And you actually enjoying like the environment down there?
Cause enjoying it, you know. It's more chilled, it's a nice environment. It's a nice gym, yeah, and 100%. All the players are nice in there, welcoming. I've been there for a few weeks now, so I'm just used to it now. But yeah, no, it's good.
I can't see him staying there much longer, though.
I can't see him.
Not with what we just said then about what? Manchester accent.
I know, yeah, I can't.
The next time I'm in there, I'm coming in with my Arsenal.
You won't even
come in with my Arsenal.
Yeah, you can't even come in Manchester with your Arsenal top.
Never mind,
Manchester. You can't even walk on Manchester with a fucking Arsenal top on. It's crazy.
When I think
you got Manchester United, you got Manchester City, and him walking around, and he's from London as well.
Ain't Arsenal playing Man City soon?
It's another composition.
Yeah, it's another day, isn't it? we'll chat when Arsenal win, yeah.
Well, it's good to catch up with you and everything like that. And I'll see you down the gym soon.
Yeah, yeah.
Cheers.
Thank you. Yeah, see you.